Hello dears, we are discussing gastrointestinal physiology, and in the past class we have discussed the functional anatomy of liver, then functions of liver and jaundice and its types. So in this presentation we will be discussing about the secretory function of liver. So which is a main secretion done by liver? It is a bile. So the bile is secreted at the rate of 600 to 1000 ml per day. And what is the function of this bile? The bile has digestive function and also excretory function. We will deal with the functions of bile in detail. But this is just an introduction. So bile has digestive function. So does bile has any enzymes in it? No. Bile doesn't have any enzymes in it, but it is rich in bile acids. And this bile acids helps in emulsification of fat and also absorption of digested fat by forming micelles. Then bile serves as a means for excretion of several important waste products. We have discussed jaundice in the past presentation. So you know that through bile, bilirubin is excreted. What is bilirubin? It is an end product of hemoglobin destruction. And then excess of cholesterol is also excreted through bile route. So let us discuss the biliary secretion today. In this presentation, answer for all these questions are present. These questions are frequently asked questions in your examination. So after this presentation, either you write notes for all these questions, or you have to underline it in your textbook, or you have to take down lecture notes, anything. But you need to study all these five questions. Okay, functions of bile, difference between hepatic and gallbladder bile, then name bile acids and their functions, then understand the importance of enterohepatic circulation, and the mechanism and regulation of bile secretion. All these questions are important. In the past class, we have studied about the functional anatomy of liver, like the polygonal lobules present in the liver, and then the central vein, then hepatocytes radiating as spokes in a bicycle from the central vein towards the periphery. Then we have studied the portal triad, consisting of portal vein, portal artery, and portal vein, hepatic artery, and the bile duct. Then we have studied all those things. So here also I am just pasting that figure here. You can see the hepatocytes. You can see the canaliculus. So the bile is formed in the liver and is excreted through the bile ductules. Then the formation of bile takes place in two stages. The first secretion is by hepatocytes, and the hepatocytes secrete a secretion which is rich in bile acids, then cholesterol and other organic compounds, and this secretion is extruded into the bile canaliculi. You can see the bile canaliculi there. So this is the first stage, the secretion from hepatocyte which is rich in bile acids, cholesterol and other organic compounds. So the first secretion is done by hepatocytes, and the next secretion, which is watery secretion rich in sodium and bicarbonate ions, this will be secreted by the cells lining the duct system. So the duct system means through the canaliculi which is situated nearby the hepatocytes, right? So through the canaliculi, the initial secretion will flow towards the interlobular septa. Then in the interlobular septa, there the canaliculi will empty into terminal bile ducts, and these terminal bile ducts join together to form hepatic duct. Then hepatic ducts are right and left hepatic ducts. These right and left hepatic ducts join together to form common hepatic duct, and from this common hepatic duct, bile can be delivered into the duodenum, or the bile can be temporarily diverted into the gallbladder cystic duct. Then this common bile duct combines with the pancreatic duct, and it opens to the second part of duodenum through sphincter of Oddi. All this you have studied in your plus 2 classes. The sphincter of Oddi, common bile duct, then pancreatic duct, all these things. In this cause, the watery secretion rich in sodium and bicarbonate ions will be added to the secretion. So the watery secretion is a contribution of the cells lining the duct system. Okay, cells lining the duct system, and secretin hormone acts here. We have studied about secretin hormone. The secretin hormone has action in liver secretion also, and that action is here in the duct system. So in presence of secretin, there will be more water-rich, sodium-rich, bicarbonate-rich ions. Sodium-rich, bicarbonate-rich secretion from the liver. Then bile is continuously synthesized and secreted from the liver, and it is stored in gallbladder. This gallbladder is a small sac. So sac-like structure with a capacity of 30 to 60 ml, and it temporarily stores bile. It will concentrate bile. It will little acidify the bile. There are different functions for gallbladder that we will discuss. Composition of bile is very, very important. Okay, what is the color of bile? It is greenish yellow color or golden yellow color. And why it has that greenish yellow color? Because of the presence of the bile pigments. Then pH of the hepatic bile is 8. So what is the pH of hepatic bile? It is 8. But after storage in gallbladder, the bile becomes little bit acidic. So its pH might reach 7. Okay. Then bile is composed of water 98% and solids that may include bile salts and pigments and different ions. You need to study the solids in human bile. See, it is listed in the chart. Bile salts are there, then bile pigments are there, then cholesterol is there, then lecithin is there, then inorganic salts are there, fatty acids, fat, alkaline phosphatase, cations like sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, anions like bicarbonate, chloride, sulfate and phosphate. The composition of bile is very important. Okay, you need to by heart the composition of bile. Next is the difference between hepatic and gallbladder bile. We have studied that bile secretion, the initial bile secretion happens from the hepatocytes, which is rich in bile salts, bile pigments and cholesterol. Then on its way through the duct system of the liver, more and more watery secretion, sodium and bicarbonate secretions will be added into the bile, and then this bile will reach the gallbladder via cystic duct. This bile is temporarily stored in gallbladder, and gallbladder performs three important functions. One is the storage of bile. Then next is the acidification of bile, means the hydrogen ion is secreted from the gallbladder cell into the bile to make the bile more acidic. And next is concentration of bile. So how is this bile concentrated? Gallbladder epithelial cells, active transport of sodium will take place. That means the sodium will absorb from the bile into the gallbladder cell, and from the gallbladder cell the sodium will be transported into the blood, and hydrogen ions will be exchanged for this sodium ions by means of sodium hydrogen exchanger pump. Okay. And when sodium is absorbed from the bile, chloride will be also absorbed for maintaining the ionic equilibrium, and water will also follow the ions. So concentration of bile will happen, and at last the bile will be very rich, especially in bile salts, cholesterol, lecithin and bilirubin. This concentration can happen up to 5-fold normally, but it can be concentrated up to a maximum 20-fold. Normally, 5-fold concentration takes place inside the gallbladder, and there is secretion of H plus ions. So the pH, hepatic bile is alkaline, but gallbladder bile is acidic. Then water content, it is 98% hepatic bile, but only 85% in gallbladder bile. Then solids, 2 grams are present. There are 10 to 15 grams are present. Why? Because of the concentration, more and more water is absorbed. So this is the difference between hepatic and gallbladder bile. Next is the formation of bile acids and bile salts. Formation of bile acids is a very important question in your exam point of view. So the bile acids are generated by the hepatocytes. So which are the precursor molecules of this bile acids? It is nothing but the cholesterol. So you eat cholesterol-rich foods, or you know that fat metabolism take place inside the liver. So the liver can synthesize a lot more cholesterol. So either from the food or from the inherent synthesis of cholesterol by the liver, you get cholesterol. And this cholesterol will be acted upon by the hepatocytes, and they convert this cholesterol into what? Bile acids. Primary bile acids. So primary bile acids are formed by hepatocytes from cholesterol. So you know that the cholesterol is having a sterol group, which is fat soluble, and also it has a polar group, which is water. So the primary bile acid form amphipathic molecule. and they also have detergent properties. You need to remember this. You need to remember this point, that is, bile acids are having a fat soluble sterol group and a water soluble polar group. This is very important when you come to the functions of bile acids. And then what will happen? This primary bile acids, which are secreted by the hepatocytes from cholesterol, they will be conjugated with two proteins, mainly glycine and lastly taurine, to form glycocholic acid and taurocholic acid. So why you need this conjugation? In order to increase the ionization capacity of the bile salts, and also to enhance the solubility, and also to prevent precipitation. So the conjugation of the bile acids help in all these things. And then what will happen? These conjugated bile acids produce salt with sodium and potassium. So the salts will be sodium taurocholate, sodium glycocholate, potassium taurocholate and potassium glycocholate respectively. So they are called the bile salts, and see, the liver will prepare about 0.6 grams of bile salts daily. And this bile salts will be secreted into the bile, and through the bile salts will reach the intestine, and in the intestine, that means duodenum, first duodenum, then jejunum, then ileum, and then colon. So in the terminal ileum and colon, what will happen is, these bile salts, they get deconjugated into, again, primary bile acids. Okay, they get deconjugated into primary bile acids. Some amount of the primary bile acids will be absorbed back into the portal circulation, and then the remaining amount of bile acids, what will happen is, the remaining amount of bile acids will be acted upon by the intestinal bacteria. You know that there are a lot more species of bacteria harbors in your intestine, and this bacteria will take up this primary bile acids, and they will be converted into deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid, which are the secondary bile acids. Very, very important. Primary bile acids are formed by the hepatocytes, while secondary bile acids are formed in the intestine by the action of what? Gut microbiota. Very important. Very important. So primary bile acids, then they will be conjugated with glycine and taurine. Then they form sodium and potassium salts, and that will give bile salts. This bile salts will be secreted into the bile, and through the bile it will reach the intestine, and in the intestine it will be deconjugated, and that primary bile acid some amount will be absorbed into the portal circulation. The remaining amount will be acted upon by the intestinal bacteria to convert it into secondary bile acids, and these secondary bile acids will also be absorbed in the portal circulation. We will visit. It is called enterohepatic circulation. And through the portal circulation, where will this portal circulation finally end? It will end in the liver, right? We have studied it in liver physiology. So through portal circulation, all these bile salts, bile acids again will reach liver. Again, hepatocytes will take these bile acids from the portal blood, and again this cycle happens, and that is called enterohepatic circulation. We will discuss it in detail in the coming slides, okay? Next is about the functions of bile salts. The main important function of bile salt is absorption of fat. So you know that fat digestion mainly takes place by the presence of enzyme pancreatic lipase in the pancreatic juice. Then these pancreatic lipase will split up. Most of the triglycerides of the diet are split by this pancreatic lipase into free fatty acids and monoglycerides. But you need to know that the hydrolysis of triglycerides is a reversible process. So immediately when these monoglycerides and free fatty acids are formed from the triglycerides, they should be removed from the vicinity of that place, because otherwise it will block the further digestion of this fats. So bile salts will help in that. How? Because you know that bile salts have two ends. One is a polar end and the other is a fat soluble end. So 20 to 40 bile salts will come, and they will attach to this monoglycerides or free fatty acids at their fat soluble end and projecting this polar end towards the outside. So that will form a spherical molecule. So 20 to 40 molecules of bile salts, they will attach to the monoglyceride, or they will attach the free fatty acids, forming a spherical molecule, and that spherical molecule is called micelles. And through the formation of these micelles, the free fatty acids and monoglycerides will be transported from the vicinity of the lipid digestion, and these micelles also help in absorption of the fats into the brush border of the intestinal epithelial cells. So like that, bile salts help in absorption of fat. Then bile salts help in emulsification of fat. How is that happening? You know that bile salts have a fat soluble end. So big fat molecules will be attached with the bile salt, with this fat lipophilic portion of the bile salt. And then what will happen is these bile salts will reduce the interfacial tension of the globule. So when during agitation, that means when the small intestine moves, you have studied movements of small intestine like segmentation movement, peristaltic movement, etc. So when the small intestine movement happens, what will happen is there occurs agitation of this molecule, and when the interfacial tension of the molecule is less, what will happen? The molecules will be splitted up. So when the molecules are splitted up, the big fat molecules are splitted up by reducing their surface tension, what will happen is the pancreatic lipase will get more surface area for its activity, for its digestion. Okay, so bile salts will help in emulsification of fats. Then source of bile acid, we have seen that primary bile acids will be, some amount will be absorbed in the portal circulation. Then secondary bile acids will be, some amount will be absorbed in the portal circulation, and about 95% of the bile acids will be absorbed back into the portal circulation, and this bile acids will be utilized for the formation of again bile salts, and that is called enterohepatic circulation. So bile salts are converted to bile acids, and so they form important source of the bile acids. Next function is it will help in bile secretion. So those will help in bile secretion are called choleretics. Okay. So bile salts act as choleretics. Then it will help in absorption of fat soluble vitamins. Then it will activate pancreatic enzymes like pancreatic lipase. It will prevent the gallstone formation. Precipitation of cholesterol occurs in gallstone. So cholesterol will be remaining soluble with the help of this bile salts and lecithin, and so it will help in preventing gallstone formation. Then bile salts act as physiological purgatives. That is why in obstructive jaundice you get constipation. The normal stool color is due to the presence of bile salts. Then it will also prevent bacterial growth. So all these are the functions of bile salts, very important. Next is enterohepatic circulation of bile acids or bile salts, which is very important, which is a very frequently asked question. So what does this enterohepatic circulation means? So from the intestine to the liver, from the liver to the intestine, then again from the intestine to the liver, that's a loop, that's a loop pathway. Enterohepatic circulation is a loop pathway from liver to intestine and from intestine back to liver. So how is this occurring? Bile acids are formed in the liver, then this bile acids and bile salts are secreted into the bile from the liver, and this bile will reach the intestine, and from the intestine, conjugated bile salts, some amount of the conjugated bile salts will be absorbed into the portal blood. Then the rest of the amount of bile salts will be deconjugated, and the unconjugated bile salt is absorbed into portal circulation. Then again, free bile acids in the terminal ileum, they will get converted into secondary bile acids, and that secondary bile acids are also absorbed into the portal circulation. So 95% of the secreted bile salts will be absorbed back into the portal circulation, and when the portal circulation reaches the liver, the hepatocytes will take up all these bile acids, all these bile acids from the blood. Even if some amount of bile acid will reach the systemic circulation, that amount of bile acids will be taken up by the kidney and again sent back to the liver. So this loop pathway is called enterohepatic circulation. Now, remember, 95% of the secreted bile salts are transferred back to the liver. So only 200 to 500 milligram of the bile acids are excreted through the stool. So these bile salts or bile acids will be recycled some 18 times before their final elimination through fecus, and the fecal loss is about 500 milligrams of bile acid daily. So there is 2 to 4 grams of total bile acids present in the body, but 500 milligram of bile acid will be excreted daily, and this 500 milligram will be formed from cholesterol. So fecal excretion of bile acid accounts for an efficient medium for the loss of body cholesterol. So if you want to get rid of cholesterol, you want to get rid of the fecal you want to increase the fecal excretion of bile acid, and that will give rise to a reduction in bile acid pool, and liver will start synthesizing more and more amount of bile acid from cholesterol. Next is regulation of bile secretion. So bile secretion is influenced by cholerytics and cholagogues. So what are cholerytics? The substance that enhances secretion of bile are called cholerytics. So what are called cholagogues? The substance that causes a contraction of gallbladder, that is called cholagogues. So what are important cholerytics? One is bile salts. So bile salts in the blood will stimulate parenchymal secretion of bile. And then what about secretin? We have seen that secretin will stimulate the aqueous component of bile. Then vagal stimulation also causes weak contraction of gallbladder and also causes some amount of increased secretion from the hepatocyte. Then cholagogues, the main two cholagogues are cholecystokinin, which is a hormone, and then fatty acids. Both these act as cholagogues for the contraction of gallbladder. Functions of bile we have already discussed in all the above slides. So you need to take down the functions of what bile pigments, you need to write down the functions of bile salts, and then everything will come under the function of bile. Next is applied physiology. Applied physiology is gallstones. Presence of gallstone in biliary tract is called what? Gallstone or cholelithiasis. Then there are two types of stones present, which is called cholesterol stones and calcium bilirubinate stones. Under abnormal conditions, a cholesterol precipitate forming cholesterol gallstones. So which are the conditions? Too much of absorption of water from the bile can lead to cholesterol precipitation, or too much of absorption of bile salts and lecithin from the bile can lead to cholesterol precipitation, or too much of secretion of cholesterol can lead to cholesterol precipitation, or inflammation of the epithelium of the gallbladder can also result in precipitation of cholesterol. All these give rise to cholesterol stones. Then what is a feature? Colicky or spasmodic acute abdominal pain is a feature. Acute abdominal pain is a feature. Then it can give, it can form because of the inflammation of gallbladder, cholecystitis. Then these gallstones may be present in obstructive jaundice. We have studied that in obstructive jaundice, the bile cannot reach the intestine due to some obstruction. So the obstruction may be sometimes this stones. You need to make a 3-mark note on gallstones. It's an important question.